You mentioned about the fear. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, indeed. For grown-ups or adults who never learned how to swim, the lack of the knowledge is most of the time will result in fear of water. That can be at any level. Some people just do not know how to move in water, but they're easily to learn and they're comfortable in water quite easily. Some adults have a sincere fear of water, and that is most of the time caused by the fact that they had a negative experience in the water. Some students, they told me that their parents just threw them in the pool or in the sea, and they assumed they will learn by themselves. Well, obviously that's not a fun way to start. Other adults, they explained me about their traumatic experience in water. They had almost drowned. They almost drowned in water, or they were on the boat which was sinking. And even worse stories. Some people told me about how they witnessed how they lost one of their siblings in water. I can't even imagine how horrible that must be. But still, they're brave enough to come to our school, so we welcome them with open arms, as you can understand.
Do you need to let them overcome the fear?
Our swimming lessons are not just about swimming. It's the mindset that matters. So after the intake chat we have prior to the first lesson, we have a better understanding what the swimmer has been through, but moreover what their motivates them. So if they tell me that they want to learn how to swim because they want to swim with their children, or they want to go for diving courses or a cruise, I will repeat it many times, because if you know what is ahead, if you know what's your motivation, you're more keen to deal with the fear. Secondly, we explain a lot about swimming, but also about the power of water and how the physics of water work. And if you have a better understanding, it's easier to learn a new skill. So that's definitely part of our program.
If the fear is that intense, why not going to a psychologist?
Fair question. Listening to all the stories my students bring, wow. They really, really went to bad times. So in general, we're still able to help them. We do it one-on-one, one-on-two, or one-on-five, whatever they prefer. It only happens one or two times that I advise the swimmer to ask for extra professional help, because the level of trauma was so intense and there was so much more going on than only the swimming issue. But other than that, we are ready to assist any student, no matter what happened in their lives. Myself, I am an NLP coach now. It's called a neuro-linguistic programmer. And with that skills, I'm able to change the mindset of the swimmers. Because swimming is not just a matter of learning what to do, it's the mindset which is in the way most of the time. So just to give an example what that means. If swimmers come to us and they tell us, I can't swim, I can't swim, we let them rephrase that sentence. We tell them, tell yourself you can't swim yet. That opens the window of opportunities. At this point, when you can't swim yet, we're going to tell you how to swim. We're going to teach you the skills. And that is the learning process what we offer. And that's applicable for all of them, no matter what their level of fear is.
You love swimming, obviously. Isn't it hard to understand people with fear of water?
It's not hard to understand our swimmers, and we're definitely ready to welcome them and to get started. So to all of you, book a triad lesson and see for yourself.